So Brandon? Brandon?
Yeah.
Yeah. How you doing?
I'm good.
You're welcome. You're going to 311 West 75th place, right?
It's in Merrillville, right?
Yeah, Merrillville, Indiana. first one?
Yeah.
Alright.
So much.
You're welcome, have a good night. Thank you. Hi, Pete.
Morning.
Good, how you doing?
You got a cord I can use for charging, by any chance?
Charger?
iPhone.
You were your 520 North Grand.
Yeah. Hello? Yeah, buddy, Peter Choros, I was spandrels painting. I was wondering if that wire harness came in and you guys went up to Michigan City to replace it. I asked for the service coordinator. Hey, bud, how are you? Peter, I had that unit in Michigan City. I was out of town. I was wondering, did you ever get up there and change the harness? Michigan City, Indiana, remember that one motor you sent the mechanic out there and then you had to order the wire harness? Buddy, no, you already looked at it and you even overnighted the wire harness last week. I thought it'd be done. I don't remember. Let me talk to him if I can. Jeff, hi, Peter, with the recycler, or that unit in Michigan City that you ordered the wire harness for?
From Spanos, right?
Yeah, you did that already, right? Or
what's that, the harness?
Yeah.
No, not yet. No, I was calling you to see if it was okay to get up back out there, but I never got back from you.
Oh, I thought that day we overnighted it. It was understood. That's why I paid for the overnight. Okay, I just got back into town. Okay.
And I called you on Thursday, and then I called you back on Friday. The harness that we got, they sent us a on your engine harness, not the one that goes between that puppy panel and the engine.
Did you get that now?
That's what they're working on right now. The parts department is working on trying to locate that correct one. Because the particular filter unit, the engine and puppy panel were assembled by
yeah.
Like a while.
Yeah.
Okay. And then that package was put into your unit. They're dealing with some superior diesel to try and get that harness, the interface harness between a perfect panel and the engine. And they shipped us the engine harness and not that perfect panel jumper.
Did you call them today?
Let me get the parts department to find out. Can I give you a call back here?
Please, because I'm in a pinch, brother. I was in a rural area. That's why you didn't get a hold of me Thursday or Friday.
Oh, okay. I was wondering because I
yeah.
Reach you, you know?
All right. All right. Please
see. I'll give you a call back.
Because I need it. I need to, because once it's, I need to take it down south for a big job and I got no time. You know what I'm saying? Okay.
Yeah, let me find out what the status is and I'll give you a call back. Yeah.
Dale, please. Dead, bro. You record your whole drive, huh, man?
Yeah.
Just how come
for
you
safety.
Do that?
Huh?
How come you do that?
Just for safety, you know, like if someone hit me or something, anything, if any passenger, you know, like try to, you know, so I can just flip the camera.
Do you ever have problems with passengers?
Yeah, like a couple of times. So since then I
what
just,
do they do like
one time one passenger said that I'm going to kill you and he was psycho or something and he was sitting right next to me so I record it after that and in the end of the day I delete it and again new recording another day.
What was he drunk?
No, he was not drunk but he looks like he was psycho or crazy. He was not, you know, like thinking straight or something.
Did he hit you or no?
No, he didn't hit me. He just said, he actually, like, when I picked him up, he said, show me your hand. I showed him his hand. And then he, you know, like, he smelled my hand. He said, then, you know, like, we were talking. I said, why did you smell my hand before in the beginning? He said, I smell that if you are a good or bad person. I said, what did you smell on me? He said, you are a good person. I was, what if I was bad? If you were bad, I was going to kill you. I was like, what are you talking about? Then he was talking a lot of, you know, crazy stuff. That I do that. I'm a person of God and all that stuff.
Did you call the police? Or?
I cannot use my phone to call police, you know. He was sitting right next to me.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
When you dropped him off, what did he say?
I just drop him, like when he said that, like I was going to kill you, then I stopped, you know, like stopped talking to me. I was just saying, yeah, okay. Because I was like, maybe if I say something wrong and he doesn't like it, what if he, you know, like stab me or something, who knows. And then he asked me like, can I smoke in your car? I was scared. I said, yeah. Then what he was doing was putting ashes in his hand and rubbing on his face, doing all kind of crazy stuff.
Did you tell Uber?
Yeah, I complained to Uber. They said we will review, but Uber does nothing, you know. They just care about their passengers. They don't care about drivers.
Wow, they figured you suspend a guy like that from using the service.
Yeah. That was a long time, like when I started driving in 2013, back in 2013.
Anything else crazy happened?
That was like one time, that was in a downtown Chicago. There was a drunk lady. She was saying that I was on this side of the street, the bar was on the other side. And like 2 days before that happened, I had a ticket for making a U-turn in a Michigan and a state street. So she was saying that, no, you make a U-turn and come to pick her up on the other side of the street. I said, I made a U-turn somehow. Then she was mad and she was using the bad words on me. I said, why are you using bad words? I don't want to get ticket. So then she said, yelling at me. I just stopped the car. I said, get out of my car. I don't want to take you to the destination.
What'd she say?
She said, take me to the destination or I'll call the police and tell you were trying to rape me. I was like, what the heck? Then, you know, like, I just drop her off. Because, you know, if she says something to police will, you know, listen to the ladies, you know.
So you record every girl?
After that, like, a lot of things happened, then I now, you know, record everything. So right now it's just recording outside, but if anything happens, I can just flip it. And you know, whatever we are talking, it's recording on the camera, so I have a proof, you know, like I'm doing nothing wrong. So yeah.
Do you ever have people throw up in your car?
Yeah, a couple of times. And I get detailed cleaning, but the Uber gives money. If you report Uber, they give you like $200.
Really?
Yeah. For detailed cleaning.
Dale, please. Dale, how are you? Peter.
Hey, what's going on, man?
Did they look at that flatbed yet?
Really?
Okay, just remember, don't pull the engine or anything. Just if they can do the tape. If they can do the tape thing, cool. If not, we just got to figure something out. All right. You're going to get to it this week, you think?
Yeah, I'll get to it this week.
All right.
Yeah.
Did he pay?
Yes, he paid everything.
I told you, that's how you gotta handle Mitch. There's no other way to handle Mitch. All right, Dale.
All right.
All right, buddy. Terry.
Sure, how are you?
Oh, I just got in from Miami. I'm on my way to my yard in Grand Point to pick up a truck.
What?
Good time.
I'm glad to hear
A little Russian influence this time. Nice. Nice. It was. You gonna go have a drink today?
Yeah, probably.
What time you gonna get there? About 4 or 4:30?
Probably
5-ish. Alright. Cool. Alright. Yeah, people nowadays, I tell my kids that all the time. Somebody says something to you, you don't have to answer them. People kill over nothing today.
Yeah. Mechanic work?
Construction,
okay.
Where are you from?
I'm originally from Pakistan.
I'm from Greece originally.
Oh, okay.
You go back a lot?
Yeah. Like once in a year, twice in a year.
You feel safe when you're there?
Sorry, where?
Pakistan. You feel safe when you're there?
Yeah. The city I used to live, it's a very safe city, you know, like nothing. The only dangerous part, which is has a border with Afghanistan, you know, that part is dangerous. The rest of the country is safe.
Is life cheap in Pakistan?
Yeah, cheaper than here.
Like, could you live on $100 a week in Pakistan if you had to?
$100? Yeah. Some people are still living, you know, like, they make, you know, $100 a week, yeah.
But it's very hard.
It's like kind of middle.
So it's not a low wage.
Yeah. So if you're making like, let's suppose $1,000 a month, is good, you know. You can make good.
Good life.
Yeah, you can have a good life. Like average middle class life, you know.
So $2,000 a month, you have everything.
Yeah.
You're like a rich guy over there.
Yeah, $2,000 a month.
How is it with women? Have they progressed a little bit or not really?
Women?
Yeah.
Not a lot of women are, you know, open-minded. They work. They go out.
The men, they drive. They let them drive and
stuff. Yeah, like, they were driving in Pakistan. There was no restrictions. The restrictions were in Saudi Arabia. In Pakistan, women were out driving, I guess, for so long. I never heard, like, women were not allowed to drive. Since I, you know, like, born, I never heard about it. But, you know, like, a lot of women, they didn't used to work back in the days. But now women are getting education.
Yeah.
And they are, you know, working in a very good fields.
Could a woman be a doctor if she's smart?
Yeah. We had a woman president.
Mm-hmm, sure.
Oh, yeah, like, back in some 90s something.
Hey, son, I called you a few times today. What? I even texted you. You're the only one that didn't answer me. I love you. Anyways, leave the IQ before you go. I'm here. I'm on my way to the warehouse. I just took an Uber because I figured you have football. But what do you want to eat for dinner tonight? What? What time you got football? Okay, but I don't want her to hesitate. Just I don't want her to wait till I'm there. Tell her to bring them and leave them there, okay? All right. What do you want to eat? All right. The women wear burqas in Pakistan too?
Sorry, what? Burqas?
Yeah,
some women, it depends on a woman. If she wanna do it, she do it. If she doesn't wanna do it, then, you know, like a lot of women, they wear sleeveless and skirts and
really?
Yeah. But they are mostly rich women, you know. They are, you know, open-minded, broad-minded.
Educated.
Yeah. So who are rich women, they wear everything. There's like a lot of parties, underground parties, you know. Pakistan, they are drinking liquor, so everything happening, you know. It's just, you know, whatever media shows that is dangerous and all that, but back, it's everything is open.
Yeah, Tom. Yes. Why, what's Nicky saying, no? All right, you can't do it for 1 second, that's fine. Just, we'll see what happens. Call me after football. All right. Where do you live?
Huh? Sorry?
Where do you live, brother?
I live in Highland, Indiana. So you, do you guys do house inspection too?
No.
No?
You ever have some people lie and complain?
Yeah.
Do they always believe the customer or no?
Yeah, like it happened twice. Like someone complained that I was driving drunk, and then you know, like I report them that I don't drink at all. If you want to take a my drug or alcohol test, you can just take it. But they said we are doing investigation. I was like, what kind of investigation they're doing? Maybe they, you know, like called another passenger who I took, and they asked them, did I look drunk or anything? Or they must have said no. So, but they you know, like turned off my account for like deactivated my account for 2-3 days, and then they opened after, you know, like 2-3 days.
Oh, so you couldn't work for 2-3 days?
Yeah, I couldn't work for 2-3 days.
So that's your probably worry. That's your job.
Yeah, and I do it full time, you know. That's what I said, Uber, you know, like you guys are believing more to the passenger than their driver, you know.
What did they say?
They say, we are sorry, this is the safety, you know, for our safety, your safety, passenger safety and all that. But that happened twice, yeah.
Straight.
Go straight over.
Right here.
Have a good one.
Mm-hmm.
You leaving your phone?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you.
You're welcome.